Hello everybody, welcome to the next episode of What the Future. About 2 weeks ago, I was invited at a DAX 30 meeting of the compensation and benefits heads. So as you might know, HR forecast is all about skills, while their profession is all about payment. How do these connect? Let's call it skill-based compensation. Let's quickly set the scene here. Today, you are usually paid for who you are, what rank you have, what role you have, or what kind of education you have. But this is not the reality anymore. Because the flaw is, today's business world works in a different way. Because everything is so dynamic, business cycles are fast, business models change rapidly, and everything is becoming more and more agile. And that also means the half-life of skills is being reduced tremendously. And for that reason, people cannot be paid anymore for who they are or what role they have, but what they can do, what kind of skills they have. This is also what we nowadays call a gig economy, because in an agile world, you are rewarded of what you can do, but not what role, what hierarchy, what position you have. In the US, some software engineers make $200,000 or more, while others make maybe only $40,000 or $50,000. They have the same role, but they have different skills. One set is not rewarded as much on the market as the other one. Now, let's translate that to Germany and see why it doesn't work right now in our country. Because you can hardly tell a well-deserved manager that has been in the company for, let's say, 30 years, why they now make less money than somebody who is young and new in the company but has some skills that are really highly rewarded on the market. And there are some more limits to it. In the end, skill-based compensation doesn't solve some of the current problems because people should be paid for output and not for input. And just by changing from being paid for roles to skills doesn't really change much. Also, there are so-called skill trends. If you look back about 10 years, search engine optimization was on the market, highly, highly paid, and nowadays it's becoming a commodity. So all these trends that are coming up and down will also lead to always changing very dynamic salaries, and in the end salaries also need to be a bit plannable for both the employee as well as the employer. So here's my bottom line. The logic how people are being paid for must change. However, there's still very, very many obstacles that need to be overcome. What it needs is courage, innovation, and the will to change things. Feel free to join us on this quest to make compensation fit for the 21st century. It's a very steep staircase, but we can take it step by step. Thank you for watching and see you next time.